Let me see the label on that old bottle. It's covered in dust, but this writing... Could it be? It is! The wine of kings, the king of wines, the commandari of Cyprus! The Knights Templar once sold this wine! Smiling! My friend, I could dance for joy! This is a vintage only grown on the island of Cyprus. There's nothing like it on Aeternum. No substitute. The nobles would sell the very clothes off their backs for a mere sip. I dare not risk so valuable a vintage. If I tried to carry it with my luck, something terrible would happen. Can you bring this priceless treasure to Pulley? By itself, it'll erase all her debts. Certain. I would love to deliver it myself, but I'm content knowing Pulley's saved. Be careful. Don't wave that bottle around, or anyone who knows its value will be after your blood.
all this now? A bottle of wine? I didn't order this. It's a generous gift, but what's all this about? Jacob? Jacob Evans? Good gracious, that poor kind man. He suffered so, yet he still thinks of me and my humble... Let's see what we have here. Commandaria? From the island of Cyprus? Oh, this is enough to save my bar and then some. I could even buy a nice little cottage with what's left over.
fine piece of liver and a perfect ram's horn. You sure you haven't done this before? Now, we shave off a bit of the horn, grind up some liver, and there it is. A healthy addition to Anwer's ancient miracle elixir. My great aunt always said liver was good for you. Though I admit you're right about the smell. It could use some work. Nobody wants to buy an elixir that smells foul. My perceptive friend, fancy meeting you again. Do you remember my ancient miracle elixir? You wound me. Yes, the latest version of the elixir was pungent, but I know how to solve that little problem. Hydrangeas. They were my grandfather's favorite blossom. They'll do the trick. I just know it. Such lovely hydrangeas. You, my friend, have a knack for spotting good potion ingredients. Look, they even improve the elixir's color, not just the scent. I think we have gold in a bottle here. Finally, we reach my favorite part. Distributing free samples to needy townsfolk. Once they've had a taste, they'll be throwing coin at me for more. Do let me know how it goes. Who better than you? You've got the heroic look, and you radiate a certain aura of trustworthiness. It's a gift that not all of us have, especially not me.
You have recovered the relic from Invictus? Go. Now. Don't say a word. Simply cast it into the pyre.
Justice is not misplaced, but we must forge our own justice. Lead, shepherd, step into my embrace. Let us protect Eternum together.
There. Now we can safely say this whole sordid affair is concluded, with some measure of redemption. Letheld is a champion of righteousness and justice. And a strong leader. Quite. The Covenant is as much about preserving hope as it is about seeing justice done. It is better for all of us that Letheld stays focused on the future. No need to dwell on these dark events. You have proven yourself to be faithful and courageous, an inspiration for any whose souls are in peril.
The whole Enclave is talking about what you've been doing around here. I can't believe we met on the side of a road. I believe it's time you officially became one of us. What do you say? I am thrilled to hear you affirm your interest. The Covenant will shine brighter with you standing in our ranks. Go and speak to Lumen Beza. I have already vouched for your worthiness. And hope be with you. Always.
Based on what I've heard from Adjudicator Letheld and Lumen Morellis, your courage is incontestable. If you are ready to swear your allegiance to the Covenant, we would welcome you into the Order. Based on what I've heard from Adjudicator Leopold and Lumen Morellis, your courage is incontestable. If you are ready to swear your allegiance to the Covenant, we would welcome you into the Order. Based on what I've heard from Adjudicator Leopold and Lumen Morellis, your courage is incontestable. If you are ready to swear your allegiance to the Covenant, we would welcome you into the Order.
side.
Let me guess. One of Anweir's?
Don't look surprised.
Any packages meant for the household can be given to me. What's this? Anweir's Ancient Miracle Elixir? What a bizarre name. The label says it cures all aches, ailments, and heartaches. How could a potion cure heartache? Oh, I do feel less tense after a few sips. That's a pleasant surprise in these trying times. Thank you.
As of today, I've sold at least a dozen orders of Anweir's Ancient Miracle Elixir. They're going faster than I can make them. And of course, I would never forget to pay my best friend in this endeavor. Of course it did. Hope is more potent than any potion. Though we live forever, ailment, despair, and darkness still plague us. Sometimes all we need to step back from the brink is a small sip of hope.
The light of the Covenant shines within you.
Yeah. light of the Covenant shines within you.
are you? You have a dangerous look about you. If you think I'll be easy prey, you're sadly mistaken. Go ahead, make your move. Out here, that's a critical trait, lest you wind up corrupted or lost. And don't try to tell me a settlement would be safer. I'll not be trusting my fate to some bumbling constable. I am, or at least I was. The Keep Up the Road, Stonereach was my home until these swine-loving soldiers showed up. Don't recognize their banners, don't know who they are or why they're here, but I want them out! A mercenary, are you? I knew it. Fine. Go to the Keep and learn what you can. Feel free to leave none alive. They've got a camp to the west, too. I'm headed to scout that out. Meet me there when you've dealt with these louts.
Ah, you dealt that laughing bastard a thrashing. Well done. The wolves finally met a more vicious wolf. This doesn't mean I trust you, by the way. But I can't argue with your results. Did you learn why they're here? Let's see. Varangians, eh? Never heard of them. Not much to work with here. But I didn't expect much anyways. Ha! Backup plan. I'll surround the keep with enough traps so those bastards regret they ever came here.
In his report, Watcheries acknowledges your heroism. In which case, you belong here. Pridewyn has a strong tradition of heroes. Of course, we always welcome guests, and you've arrived at a most fortuitous occasion. Why, we have just learned the true heir to the throne is returning to the region. This is a day we have been awaiting for centuries, and a sign of new hope even during these troublesome times. Oh, I could recount the legends for days, but I must dispatch someone to the shore now. The Night Regent is indisposed, but Minister Lochnir runs day-to-day affairs in Pridewyn.
Well now, two new faces to Pridewyn in one day. Many a year since I've seen that. But these are special times. After centuries, the true heir returns, and the royal bloodline will once again sit upon the throne. Forgive me, I take it for granted all are aware. The heir is Sir Gawain himself, most gallant of the High King's Knights. You will have the honor to see his homecoming and the return of Pridewyn's glory after many dark years. Across the centuries, I've watched the light fade from Monarch's bluffs in the absence of a true ruler. Of course, the Night Regent has done all she can with my wise counsel, and now our patience will soon be rewarded. Only a matter of days. I'm personally attending to preparations even now, as is my duty. Tradition is everything, wouldn't you say? One such custom I've established is that we offer our guests a complimentary room at the inn. You'll find the inn quite hospitable. I hand-selected the innkeep a few decades ago, so by all means, check in and have a warm meal by the fire. I must attend to other matters now, but we will speak again.
Corruption will claim them all. Warning them is a futile effort. They are blind to the real danger all around them.
I heard the talk around town. People saying things are safer around here. Not sure I believe it. I might just pick up and head south one of these days. Heard the talk around town. People saying things are safer around here.
Now there's a familiar face. About time you caught up. Here we find ourselves in a little village pulled straight from the Middle Ages. Is it me? Or does nothing on this island make any sense at all? No doubt. For a place where everyone gets eternal life, you'd think it'd be more calm, dull even. Not saying I'd like that, mind you. One thing that is the same, though, is cold, hard coin. You have it or you don't. Makes all the difference. We're both a little light in the pocket, but I did sell that loot we collected, so there's your share. Never let it be said Grace O'Malley doesn't pay her debts. Well, you got that coin I just gave you, so I'd suggest you get to spending it. Buy yourself a new blade, some new boots, whatever suits your fancy. Ah, yeah, there's a trading post out there. Livelier market than I would have expected. You should check out the trading post yourself, and if you need to stash anything, there's a storage shed too. Go on, I'll be here. You here just a few hours and you're already the most popular person in town. You had a caller while you were out. That overly chipper knight from the town gate dropped by, says he wants to have a word with you. That Sir Payne and Minister Lochnear talk this place up like it's got a grand history and a bright future, but I'm not buying it. Word in the tavern is that Pridewin's overrun with people fleeing from trouble at the outlying farms. Sounds like some kind of plague. People turning on their friends and neighbors with cold murder in their eyes. Unlike those red-eyed bastards on the beach, these folks aren't possessed. Seems like they don't have any souls at all. I didn't trust all the shite coming out of that watcher's mouth, but maybe there was some truth to it. Ask Sir Payne about these soulless lost outside town. Maybe get a more honest idea of what's happening here.
Excellent to see you again. Perhaps Miss O'Malley can be trusted after all. As to you, however, the Watcher's report guarantees it. In fact, the Night Regent would like to discuss a rather delicate situation, if you're willing. Oh, so you have heard the unfortunate news from outlying areas. I'm sorry to hear that. We try not to worry newcomers with such things, but we've even had some knights who failed to report in. Yes, well, I hope... well, I mean, I have the utmost confidence this will be cleared up before the heir arrives. I think the Night Regent simply wants to take precautions. Please speak with her when you can.
Come in and be welcome. I will never forget the way this island tested me when I first arrived. I strive to ensure we are patient with newcomers. And in these times, our customs are even more difficult to observe. That is good to hear. I believe Sir Payne represents us well, and the spirit of everything Pridewen stands for. However, with all the anticipation surrounding Sir Gawain's return, we risk letting our optimism turn into denial. 4 weeks now. We've heard horror stories from people fleeing the farms, grieving the loved ones that turned on them. Behind their words, I sense a suppressed longing to surrender their own souls to despair. We offer shelter, comfort, and we dispatched knights to secure the roads, and many never returned. Minister Lochner counsels patience. He believes the royal bloodline will solve all problems, but I feel I must act. The mines are the backbone of Pridewen, where many townspeople earn their livelihoods. I've had no reports in days. I simply ask you visit and confirm with Foreman Alia that all is well. Then report back to me, please.
Love keeps you warm, but so does wool. Come to me if you ever need something stitched. I've made a fair garment for many a fine folk, even my darling Eddie. Who isn't back yet? Yes. My foolish heart can't help long for my Eddie. He toiled too hard in the mines. This is the first time he's missed our anniversary. I'd go to the mines myself, but his favorite turkey is roasting away. That'd be lovely. Tell that Ulf he has a wife who loves him more than the mines do. And then, gently remind him that it's our anniversary today. And I'll be very cross if he doesn't have a gift for me.